Hello friends, how are you? This is Dr. Shinagi, Ayurveda and medicine doctor and also Isha Hatha Yoga teacher. So today in this video, we are going to talk about the health of our ear. As you know, ear is very essential sense organ of our body, and sometimes it happens like we are totally unaware about it. And we just keep doing things which are not so good for ear health. Not knowingly, but unknowingly, because we are not aware about it. So let's see what Ayurveda has to say about ear health. According to Ayurveda, ear is a place of ether element and air element. So all the disturbances or all the problems that happens mostly in ear are mostly related to vata imbalance. Many of us are unaware of the fact like ear is not only a hearing organ. Like we think ear is just for hearing, like if you speak something I will hear through my ear. But ear is not only this, ear is also a balancing organ of the body. As you know, this ear is been divided into three parts, that is inner ear, middle ear and outermost ear. So whenever there is some problem in ear, we also feel sometimes vertigo, that is we are not able to balance ourselves. This also happens whenever you have ear infection. Many times this happens, people complain like there is something oozing out of the ear, like some discharge is coming out of the ear. And these days I am feeling a lot of vertigo, like a lot of these something is happening, I am not able to balance myself. So if you are also among them who are feeling these kind of problems, balancing problems especially, and your ear also is giving this kind of sign, like something is coming out of the ear, though it is without pain, just itching is happening, then it is very high time that you do a proper ear checkup, because maybe medicine is needed for ear, maybe there is some inflammation, maybe there is some infection that is also related to balancing yourself. That's why, because of that infection, you are not able to balance yourself properly. So this is one thing that you need to take care of. Another thing, a very common mistake these days we are doing, because these days everything is online. Chatting is online, meetings online, conferences online, studies online, students are sitting online all the time for taking their lectures, notes. And to relax yourself, people are listening very high loud music, because they are saying that it gives them a feel of enjoyment, like only they can enjoy loud music, no other music they can enjoy. So if this is happening, you need to see like this is not only about sound. Your ear is not only about sound. If you do not take care of your ear, it will also cause long-term imbalance. Like maybe you feel starting vertigo, tinnitus. Even if somebody is speaking with normal voice, maybe you will not be able to hear it if you just keep listening louder music. So regarding this also, I would like to give you precaution, like whenever you are using headphones, try to keep its volume low. Don't keep the volume very high, because ear is also going to impact your brain. It's also going to impact your throat. It's also going to impact your jaw movement. So everything is related with ear. As you know, our nerve supply is like this. So it's very important that we take care of our ear, because if there is an infection in ear, it can travel to the sinuses also. So it's very important. If you are feeling some kind of stiffness in your neck, if you are feeling vertigo, if you are feeling imbalance and some kind of irritation or heaviness in ear, maybe it is a ear infection. So what is the proper way of doing it? You need to check it with otoscope. There's an instrument with which doctors see what is the inside thing in your ear, is there some infection or not. If it is infection, you need to take proper antibiotics. After taking antibiotics, even you need to take care of your ear in a normal way properly. In Ayurveda, regarding taking care of ear, it's very importantly been said, like never not to take out this ear wax, like daily just itching ear and just go with this any cotton wig, just people are just doing something in the ear. This is not right. This is not recommended in Ayurveda. In Ayurveda, it's been said after taking shower, make sure like if some water has went inside, you just take a cotton towel, wrap it around your finger, little finger or normal finger, and just from the outside dry it out properly. Like you tilt your head and try to dry it out. Don't take something which just to pull something inside. Don't take any sharp thing to put inside your ear. It can damage your eardrum. That is very important, and it's a very great protection for your ear. Ear has a capability of self-cleaning, so no need to remove wax or anything. Whenever it is needed, ear will throw the wax out by itself. Whenever you are using any kind of music, headphones or anything, try to keep its volume not more than 50 or 55%. Try to keep the volume as low as possible. Whenever you are doing some private conversation and you are alone sitting privately, try to use technology without any headphones. Just try to talk as it is, like without using any hearing aid. This will save your ear to a big extent. As I mentioned, in Ayurveda, ear is considered as a vata organ, and it is a place for vata also. So in Ayurveda, there is a process called Karan Puran, that is Karan Puran technique. Karan means ear. In Ayurveda, ear is known as Karan. So Karan means Karan Puran technique. There is a technique of oiling your ear. And for specific way of Karan Puran, you need a proper Ayurveda doctor who knows how to do the technique properly. But there is another way with which you can just put, you just can do oiling of the ear. How to do it? Take your this little finger, like this little one, and put some cotton cloth around it, and take some oil. It can be any oil. It can be coconut oil, sesame oil, or mustard oil. Any these of three of these oil. Make sure these oils are of organic origin. And take this oil and just apply on your outer ear, not inside, just outer ear, just everywhere on the outer ear. Like ear in this hole till where your finger will go, don't push it very hard, till to the place when it goes easily. To all this place, apply this oil and just leave it as it is. It will remove all the excessive dryness of the ear, and it will make the skin of your ear very nice, and it will strengthen your cartilage of the ear, because this is cartilage, you know, this is cartilage. It will be a very good acupressure for your ear. As you know, in ear it's been said all the acupressure points of whole body exist in ear if you go through acupressurepathy. So it's very important that you do massage just like this with the oil. Which oil you can use? You can use coconut oil, you can use sesame oil, or you can use almond oil, or you can use mustard oil. But make sure all the oil should be of good quality and of organic origin. Then only I recommend to use. If you doubt their qualities, then please don't use these oils. Then just leave your ear as it is. In addition to that, in yoga, you can do various kind of pranayams which are very beneficial. In addition to that, arm chanting is also very beneficial for the health of your ear. How in Isha we do arm chanting, like ah, oo, and ma, all the vibration goes in all of your brain. So this kind of arm chanting is also very beneficial for the health of your ear. In addition to that, all the yoga, it's very beneficial for the health of your ear, because you know, if your ear is balanced, that means it provides balance to your body, and if your body is balanced, that means it provides balance to your ear. In addition to that, if you have a habit of smoking, alcohol, these kind of things, if you are doing, then please try to reduce them, because they are not so good for the health of your ear. In addition to that, it's very important that you spend some time in nature, in calmness, in meditation. This will also make the health of your ear better in a big way. In addition to that, focus on your diet, try to have seasonal fruits, try to have freshly cooked organic food, and try to have your dinners as early as possible, if possible before sunset. That would be best time. So that's all for today's video. I hope you will like it. And if you're watching me for the first time, there is a bell icon, there's a subscription button. Please click the bell icon, hit the subscription button so that you stay in tune with our upcoming videos. Also, if you would like to support us, there's a join button near subscription button. You can click this join button and you can support us. Also, if you have any questions, please write down those questions in the comment section. I will try to answer your questions in the best possible way. Also, those of you who want Ayurveda consultations, please write to me on the given email ID and I will let you know how we can schedule it. So that's all. So with this note, I would like to say stay healthy, stay blessed, take care. Bye.